The next icons we have are insert row, delete column. Those should be pretty self-explanatory. Auto format, we're going to come back to that one in a minute. Let's go back to our table properties. What we want to pay attention to here is our width is 2.27, and we'll also notice that from the left it's 0 because we have this aligned to the left, which means the left margin. So we see our left margin, and if I move this a little bit, we can see that the end of the table right here looks like about 2.27 inches. Let's line it up on the right. Clicking the right, I'll need to click OK. And now we see that our whole table has moved to the right. We can also move it to the center. The others in there are from the left. We would change our spacing. Right now it's 2.33. We can make it 0 would position it on the left. And a negative number, we'll place it to the left of the margin. Let's move it back to the left margin just by clicking left and clicking OK to move it back. If we want to adjust the size of the table itself, we would click on the width. Let's make it 4 inches. Clicking OK, it auto-adjusts the columns to space them out evenly. We can adjust them as we like. This relative button asks us to do it in a percentage. Let's make it 25% of the width between our margins. Looking at our table format again, that explains pretty much everything here. Text flow, not much here that I really want to go into at this point. We will come back to some of these. Columns, changing the column width. The borders. Comments here are the shadow style that only works for the entire box. Line arrangement. This will work on selected cells, just as we saw earlier. Line style, color, and the spacing to the contents. We went over that. The background. We've seen this a few times. We can do a color or a graphic, just as we've seen earlier. We can do this for the cell, the row, or the table. You can put in one graphic in for each cell or put that same graphic into a row or behind the entire table. From here, we can color in the entire cell. This is different than the border background fill that we saw earlier. So if you want to fill in the entire cell of a table, we need to go into Table Properties, Background Fill in this area.